Hello and welcome to the final day of judo action from the 30th Universiade. We've seen 32 medals handed out already. The final eight will be won today in the team events. And the Japanese, as a team, are sitting top of the overall gold medal table at the Universiade with 13 golds, but just think, six of those golds are from judo. Are they about to add to that? We start with Takeda against Bobrikova.
First penalty goes to Takeda for passivity. Oh, uchigari right away for Wazari, for Takeda.
And she's been given a Wazari for that. So Japan on the up at the moment. Can she get a hold on? The hold is on. The clock is counting.
Kamishogatami is one of the tougher holds to get out, and that's exactly what she has on Bobrikova. And the second Wazari goes to Takeda for... Oh, sorry. That was...
It has now. The second Wazari gives the match to Ryoko Takeda. And Bobrikova lost her fight in the semi-finals, and she's now lost it in the final as well. So Japan, one up. So a change of personnel. Golomidova of Russia comes on. Tomizawa of Japan will take her on in the under 57 kilo category.
Both fighters came in strong. No uchigari attempt from Golomidova. She's working on a triangle reversal from there. The first penalty for gripping to Golomidova, for gripping on the same side. She has a belt grip, working on a Tsutemi Waza, sacrifice technique. Didn't manage to turn Tomizawa onto her back or side.
And in one of the bronze medal matches, Brazil are one up against Germany. It's the latest from mat three.
Golomidova tried again, another attempt with a sacrifice throw. And picks up a second penalty for passivity.
And the Koreans are one up against the French in their bronze medal match. But the Russian here in a little bit of trouble.
Bounce. There's a big attempt to throw from Tomizawa with that Tayotoshi. She's very dangerous. And she just comes across and misses a little bit on the rotation of her opponent's upper body. But it was a very strong attack, nevertheless. Left.
Yeah, I was going to say, so a minute left, time is running out. But the Russian has to be careful. Another penalty and she'll be disqualified, she'll lose the match. Three penalties and you're out.
Nice combination there. A foot sweep.
Golomidova lost her semi-final fight as well.
Uchimada attempt from Golomidova. Was a good solution for her opponent's pushing movement.
30 seconds to go. Tomizawa burst onto the scene back in 2015. She's still only 19. But since then, she's managed a bronze at the Junior World Championships, and this year took the silver at the Asian Pacific. The real force for the future, Kana Tomizawa. Can she win her fight here? Can she add to Japan's score in this team final?
Well, you see, Gomidova is smart because as she approaches the edge of the mat, she does an uchimata, which is a legitimate attack, instead of stepping out and picks up a third penalty. And now they decide this match in the golden score period.
Next score wins, whoever that will be.
And again, that uchimata on the edge of the mat from Gomidova.
She can't allow herself to be just pushed out, to step out of the mat. She'll pick up a penalty for that. So, as you say, she's putting in these clever attempted throws.
Exactly. You can see
she's got a high grip, the Japanese on the Russian.
Well, change of direction. Came in with the uchimata, tries a sacrifice technique, dropping her back.
And a penalty to the Japanese for passivity.
You can see Tomizawa's really pushing forward. Came in for a Taiyotoshi again. A very close match between these two. You can see Tomizawa likes to keep her opponent near the edge, and it really forces.
Why would that be?
Because she's trying, well, I would say she looks like she's trying to get another penalty to win the match, but also she wants to get a big reaction from her opponent because she knows her opponent doesn't want to step out, and hence Gomidova has to push back.
And oh, she just picked up the third penalty. So the Russian has lost this on penalties, and Tomizawa picks up the win to make it 2-0 to Japan. So Japan now only needs one more win to take the gold medal. So the next pair step up, Kamila Badurova of Russia wearing the blue, and on the left-hand side we'll have Nana Kota of Japan, the 21-year-old in her second Universiade, attempting to win her second gold of this Universiade.
And this is the women's under 63 kilograms weight category. And both are right-handed fighters. And pushing forward, leaning forward.
Just trying to get a measure of each other in these early stages of the fight. The first 30 seconds gone now.
They both are playing cautiously, keeping the pressure on the wrist of their opponent.
Oh, and a penalty goes to the Japanese and the Russian. It's a penalty apiece. Referee wants to see more attacking, more action.
That was an uchimata from Kota. Now you're seeing more attacks from the players. Instead of settling on a grip and stay in a static position, you can see Kota is moving, attacking at every opportunity. Deep grip from Badurova. Came in for a makikomi attempt.
Now she's trying to get a hold on, but her legs are caught up. And the thing that stands out, really, apart from the Japanese success, they've all got gold next to their names for this university, and it's just how young they are. They're all 2 or 3 years younger than their Russian opponents.
That's true.
This competition is all about the future of these sports at the Universiads. And I think we're definitely seeing strength in depth for the future of women's judo in Japan.
I think it's safe to say, oh, big Harai Makikomi. So close. Budarova got the lift for a moment there, just didn't really manage to have a complete rotation. You can see she came all the way in, tried hard to rotate. Bakota just stopped that action. Bakota's pushing forward. Also, Togari came off a Silnaki grip. Well, she's working on a turnover now, going the other direction.
So Badarova managed to avoid the Iso Togari.
Well, both are evenly matched so far in this contest.
These teams been through four matches to get to this final. So this is a fifth fight of the day for both the Russian and the Japanese judokas at the end of what will feel like a long tournament for them.
Oh, into the reverse kisagatami. Kota managed to roll her opponent.
So Kota already has a Wazari on the board.
That is another Wazari for Awasete Ippon.
That's three victories for Japan. That's the gold medal for the Japanese women. Yet again, Japan reigns in the women's categories. For Maya Akiba, who won't even have to fight here, it's her third medal of these games. For the others, it's all their second gold of the games. Nana Kota seals the deal for Japan against Russia, 3-0. Well, I promised you a minimum of six fights. A maximum of, I've lost count now, 10, wasn't it?
10, yeah.
And so far, the first one is over in three. So we're heading to a minimum of six. Well, congratulations to the Japanese. A 3-0 victory in this gold medal contest sees the women's team gold go to Japan.